Lytham is the hidden jewel in the crown of the northwest coast. Its scenic location at the mouth of the Ribble estuary, long promenade with classic Victorian and Edwardian architecture, bespoke shops and cafe culture, lovely parks, sitting, play and activity areas for all ages, and its abundance of festivals and entertainment make it an ideal town to visit. Lytham is a long-established small coastal resort halfway between Blackpool to the north and Preston to the south. It sits on the northern bank of the estuary of the River Ribble, where it meets the Irish Sea.
Well, settlement on this site dates back to medieval times, when monks from Durham were exiled here. And so they set up a priory. Just before the dissolution, the monks left and sold the land. And then various people were here over the next coming years until the Clifton family came here in 1606.
They built the first Lytham Hall, and for the next 300 years, the family exerted a strong influence on the landscape of the town.
And there's so many buildings in the town, the hospital, the market hall, all relate back to the Clifton family. There are some lovely wooded areas, and that's down to where Thomas Clifton in 1820 who took over the estate. And he planted trees just about everywhere.
Lytham's popular green on the promenade was laid out in the 1830s, mainly as a sea defence. Its famous windmill has stood on the edge of the promenade for 180 years, in spite of a disastrous fire in 1918. Lytham Heritage now preserves it as a museum. The influence of the Clifton family, as squires of Lytham, is very much in evidence today. For instance, the cobble wall, built around the Clifton estate, is visible in many areas and is well maintained. Local cobble stones are still used as building material in many present-day structures, and also as art in the town centre. The cobblestone montage depicts the heritage of Lytham. Shrimping was and still is an important part of Lytham life. The shrimping boats, although not so many these days, still go out at high tide and return with their catch, which is on the menu of many local and regional restaurants. The statue of the shrimper in Lowther Gardens commemorates this part of Lytham's history. In addition to the iconic windmill, Lytham boasts one of only two Grade 1 listed buildings in the area, Lytham Hall.
The hall's actually owned by the local community through the town trust, and when they bought the hall just over 13 years ago, they brought in another trust called the Heritage Trust for the Northwest, and these two trusts run the hall for the benefit of the local community. We've put together a bid for some substantial funding from the Heritage Lottery Fund, which hopefully will enable us to take the hall into a new dimension and be accessible to the public 7 days a week.
The grounds of Lytham Hall are a delight to wander through at different times of the year to enjoy the spectacular snowdrop, bluebell and rhododendron displays.
The outdoor events is a key part of bringing people in that perhaps wouldn't associate themselves with a historic building. So we have mega mini meets where mini car owners come. We have the outdoor theatre and musical events. So it's just having all these different things going on. And again, people can come in and enjoy the hall.
The floral displays at Lytham Hall are mirrored throughout the town from the early spring to late summer.
In 2010, we won gold at Britain in Bloom. Our objective is to work with other community groups, other trusts, work with the local council, the local businesses in the town centre, the pubs, the restaurants, the shops, to ensure that Lytham is a lovely place in which to live and work and is attractive to visitors. Over the last few years, we've planted something like 250,000 daffodil bulbs. We try to ensure that throughout the year, the floral displays are spectacular.
Today, Lytham is a thriving market town full of distinctive shops, cafes, bars and restaurants.
Generally, the town's quite bustly, really, because of all the independent shops that we have. They're all very individual, so they're very different to any other town that you'd go to. So you just find something a little bit different.
The compact town centre embraces restaurants that cater for all tastes, including Italian, Mediterranean brasseries, Indian, Thai and Chinese cuisine, and good old English fish and chips. Lytham also boasts a number of excellent pubs, with the Taps consistently recognised as one of the best real ale pubs in the country. Many of the pubs provide live music most Friday and Saturday nights. The promenade is heavily used by walkers, cyclists, dog owners and bird watchers who enjoy the magnificent views across the Ribble estuary. This area is of immense importance for wildlife in general, and in particular for some 250,000 wintering birds. Lytham prides itself in catering for the recreational needs of all age groups, boasting a number of excellent golf courses, with Royal Lytham and St Anne's Golf Club being one of the preeminent links courses in the world. It has hosted the Open Golf Championship on 10 occasions.
In 2012, I've got the Golf Open, and that draws in probably 200,000 to 250,000 people, and it's always a great event.
We'll become the centre of focus for the golfing world. It is the oldest tournament in golf, and it's the most revered. And the best players in the world will be here. Everyone from Ballesteros to Woods to Duval to Faldo, all the ones that have been number one in the world have been here. Because our course is considered so difficult, it attracts a stellar field because people, top players, want to win on the best courses, and we are one of the 10 best courses in the country. It's a very difficult golf course. 203 bunkers on the course, which I think is around about 50 more than the nearest championship venue. The 1996 Open afterwards was dubbed by the media as the Friendly Open, and I think that is really typical of this club. It's a very, very friendly golf club.
There are three large play areas, all with modern state-of-the-art equipment. The facilities for youngsters at Park View for You are particularly impressive. A community-run development program, it provides safe, extensive, multifunctional playing facilities for children of all ages.
We've got a fantastic BMX track, skate park. We've got great equipment for senior citizens. It's like outdoor gym equipment. We've got this lovely teen zone, which you can see behind me. We've got a wonderful toddler area, which is full of imaginative play equipment. And we've got this great skate park. And it's really, really well used.
This used to be a disused field where the kids used to congregate, created antisocial behaviour really, and since the park's been here, there's been a huge reduction in that.
It's just been a massive community effort. We've got lottery funding, we've got funding from everywhere, and in total we've raised somewhere like £1.5 million.
The YMCA provide excellent indoor and outdoor facilities for all, and there are a number of bowls clubs in the town. For the thespians and music lovers, Lytham caters for all tastes. In August, Lytham Green is the location for major stars performing in outdoor concerts. The last night of the Proms concert attracts world-famous artists such as Leslie Garrett.
It's going to be a three-day event. We've got Status Quo, Catherine Jenkins, and even Boyzone, which should be absolutely fantastic.
Lytham Green is also the venue for an annual St George's Day festival in April. Lytham Club Day, on the last Saturday of June each year, is the community's opportunity to celebrate its heritage together. Nearly 100 floats, church groups and bands march through the town packed with thousands of residents and visitors. Throughout the day, the town is buzzing with excitement, and the festivities carry on into the evening, with live music in many of the pubs. Lowther Pavilion stages a range of music and theatre productions throughout the year, with local theatre groups and nationally recognised artists. Lytham has so much to offer residents and visitors. History and heritage, a range of recreational activities for all ages, performing arts and entertainment, and wonderful floral displays. The community is proud to be working together to ensure that the town remains a lovely place in which to live and work, and is welcoming to visitors. So why not come and see for yourself all the wonderful things that Lytham has to offer?